Good day, everyone. We will be talking about the Article 127 of the Revised Penal Code, Expulsion. The penalty of prison correctional shall be imposed upon any public officer or employee who, not being thereunto authorized by law, shall expel any person from the Philippine Islands or shall compel such person to change his residence. There are two acts punishable under this article. First, by expelling a person from the Philippines, and second, by compelling a person to change his residence. There are three elements. First, that the offender is a public officer or employee. Second, that he expels any person from the Philippines or compels a person to change his residence. That the offender is not authorized to do so by law. Let's define first the terms included in this provision. Public officer or employee. Under Revised Penal Code, public officer as any person who, by direct provision by law, popular election, or appointment by competent authority, shall take part in the performance of public functions in the government of the Philippine Islands. Also, in Republic Act 3019, public officers as including elective and appointive officials and employees, permanent or temporary, whether in the classified or unclassified, or exempt service receiving compensation, even nominal, from the government as defined in the preceding subparagraph. Expel, the act of forcing someone to leave a place. Compel, to drive or urge forcefully or irresistibly. How about the phrase, not being thereunto authorized by law? The law defines power. No official, no matter how high, is above the law. Only the court by a final judgment can order a person to change his residence. Now let's apply the provision to the case of Zacarias Villavicencio et al. Versus Justo Lucban et al., which was decided March 25, 1919. This is a landmark case in the criminal law. For the issue, whether or not Mayor Lucban has the right to deport women with ill repute. For the facts, Manila City Mayor Lucban, together with Manila Chief of Police Anton Human, took custody of 170 women beyond the latter's consent and knowledge. Said women are inmates of the houses of prostitution situated in Sampaloc. They were shipped to Mindanao, specifically in Davao. The vessels reached their destination at Davao. They were landed and receipted for as laborers by Francisco Sales, provincial governor of Davao, and by Feliciano Inigo and Rafael Castillo. For the ruling, no. Going back to the issue whether or not Mayor Lucban has the right to deport women, the court ruled that he has no power or right to deport women. Law defines power. No official, no matter how high, is above the law. Lucban committed a grave abuse of discretion by deporting the prostitutes to a new domicile against their will. There is no law expressly authorizing his action. The prostitutes are still, as citizens of the Philippines, entitled to the same rights, as stipulated in the Bill of Rights, as every other citizen. Now let's apply the elements of Article 127. For the first element, that the offender is a public officer or employee. This element is present in this case. Both were public officer or employee, Manila City Mayor Lucban and Manila Chief of Police Anton Human. For the second element, that he expels any person from the Philippines or compels a person to change his residence. This element is also present in the case. The women were shipped to Davao without their consent and knowledge by Lucban and Human. For the third element, that the offender is not authorized to do so by law. Still, this element is present in the case. Lucban ordered certain prostitutes to be transferred to Davao without observing due process since they have not been charged with any crime. As a review, the ruling is no. Lucban has no power or right to deport the women. Also, all the elements of Article 127 are present in the case.